You never know.
Well, 2 hours or 1 hour 30 minutes, well, that would definitely be huge. Now, we're talking about under 17, of course. Ndka Ogbade will be talking to us
shortly
this morning on Nigeria's performance and also
skipper.
What is next for the Golden Eaglets. Now, this is what you have on your screen. Mm-hmm. The result, of course, on Saturday night, Nigeria and USA, Chukwudi Agoh and Victor Osimhen were the ones who ensured that Nigeria were able to pick up the first victory, of course, their opening game, and which was really crucial for them. After a goalless first half, the coach Emmanuel Amunike says he had to tell them that, look, just believe in yourself, you can do this. And of course, they came out and they were just smoking and they were able to get those 2 goals. And at the end of the day, it was all victory for the Golden Eaglets. And looking at the next game, which is going to be against his host nation, Chile. Remember when they did in Copa America? Well,
that's
the result you have in England and Guinea, where it was just a 1-0 draw for.
Imagine that.
Okay, we'll go back to that, but this is the details of Nigeria's game.
Yeah.
12 midnight, of course, that's early hours of Wednesday morning. That 12 midnight Tuesday, and of course, it's going to be on the 21st. It's going to remember what the Chileans did when they hosted the Copa America, of course. You will say, well, okay.
This is under 17.
Golden Eaglets definitely have to be ready. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. We look at what Alexis Sanchez did.
A lot of us were cautiously optimistic when this team were going. As Nigerians, we always want to win, but we're a bit skeptical about this team. But they've started well.
They've started well. That's the most important thing.
It's only fitting that we're even listening to, we'll be listening to Ndka Ogbade shortly because it was there 30 years ago.
Yeah.
Under this current president, who was a military administrator 30 years ago. So it brings, it's like nostalgia. It brings back a lot of feelings. It could tell us from the perspective of a player and from the perspective of a coach. Don't forget, it was part of the
coaching crew.
2 years ago. So it's very interesting. But these are the results for.
Okay, Nigeria, USA, of course, Brazil and Korea Republic. Now, for the very first time, you're having a country from Asia defeating Brazil. This was a shocker for me, by a lone goal. Chile, of course, Croatia, it was a 1-0 draw. So definitely Nigeria.
Good one for Nigeria.
Top there. And for Australia and Germany, 4-1. That was
never
expected. Of course, the Germans are always, well, with the machine and all that. Region and Mali, it was also a draw. Yeah, a goalless one for Mali. So you have the African teams, well, all drawing. Mexico and, of course, Argentina. Mexico beating Argentina by 2-0. I was also shocked by this result. Honduras and Ecuador, 3-1. Ecuador winning that one against Honduras. For South Africa, the fixtures for today: South Africa and Costa Rica, New Zealand and France, Korea, DPR, Russia, Syria and Paraguay, USA and Croatia, England, Brazil, Chile, Nigeria, of course, Korea Republic and Guinea. That's what you have for the next game against them. Hopefully the African teams can start winning.
South Africa is the only African team yet to play.
Okay.
They'll be playing today. So we'll see how all of that pans out. But it was a good showing for
the Africans,
Nigeria and Guinea. And we did well.
And Mali. I'm hoping.
Against the host, I may be worried. You know, but then again, with what
the
they did,
the first game was a draw, exactly.
So yeah, the first game was a draw, so that should be motivation.
If you followed it for a while, South Americans usually have a slight edge. I don't know, maybe because they play football at an early age, but again, because they have a bag of tricks.
Is more like a tradition.
Bag of tricks. Although at the under 17 level, it's not about winning, but you know, I've seen us lose. I mean, in 2003. I mean, I saw us, the John Mikel Obiset that played in Finland, I saw us lose to an Argentine side that was beaten by everybody. And just one free kick, we didn't know what to do with it. And, you know, that's why I said, I'm always cautious.
When we play South Americans.
Not because they are better,
no,
but because of those little things that you don't pay, attention to.
Yeah, the minutest of details. As far as I'm concerned, you know, regardless of whatever happens, you know, the guys have picked up a win in the first game. So which is crucial. So they shouldn't go into the game, you know, under pressure. They're the host nation, you know, just go to the game, go to the game, do what you have to do, whatever comes out of it, you know, you're still in a good stead, you know, to
enjoy yourself.
Yeah, enjoy yourself. So no pressure as far as I'm concerned. No pressure at all.
Still no pressure, but when you have the president of the federation actually saying just make this as a Christmas gift for everyone, I think there's a little one there.
All right, Christmas gifts.
It's not coming from me, right? Is it coming from me?
No, no. People in top, very highly placed, you know, I don't want to start mentioning this, but people highly placed are already, you know.
They will always have, you know, one or two things to say. Yeah, that, do this, you know, but these are young lads. These are kids. Don't put them under unnecessary pressure.
Exactly. Enjoy the game. Yeah. Mukie Ndukagbade joins us now. Good morning, coach.
Good morning, Onduka.
Yeah, good morning.
Yes, great to have you.
Cecilia, are you on the and Yemi? Good morning to you.
Good morning and good to have you here this morning.
It's my pleasure. It's my pleasure.
Now, talking about the Golden Eaglets, of course, you were with them 2 years ago and we saw the resounding victory. So this one, what are your thoughts on this particular one?
Cecilia, quite interesting. That what I was afraid of actually was just the first match against USA after hearing what the United States coach, you know, was talking about all throughout for almost about a week. And at the end of the day, I found out that Nigeria is just not just a pushover. At the end of the day, we've managed to get the 3 points, which is very, very important in every first game of any major competition.
Okay, now for them, a resounding victory and all that, its second half was really fantastic. Now, talking about the team, what do you expect Nigerians to actually do to them? I mean, Nigerian Football Federation, what they can actually do to develop it more? Because we've seen it with the last set, this set. What can they do to develop them more?
The bottom line here is that grassroots football is very, very important because it is from the grassroots football that you get players that will represent you at the under 15 level, at the under 17, under 20, under 23, and they'll go on to play in the senior national team. If you do not develop the grassroots football very, very well, what you're going to have is that you're going to have teams that will just be participating and sometimes not even qualify for even major competition. And most of the players at the grassroots too must be given adequate, you know, wonderful education on the footballing science so that at the end of the day, they are able to compete very, very well, not just going to a competition to participate. And at the end of the day, most of them will go abroad, you know, play very, very well, become stars and bring back foreign exchange for us. And they help their families and friends and cousins, and Nigeria too will be better. Most of these guys will leave the streets with knives, with glue, with cocaine and every other thing, and more people will pick up their footballing boots. This is just it, Cecilia.
Mm. All right, Coach Onduka, let's look at the next game, talking about the Golden Eaglets. They were playing Chile. Expectations definitely are high for the team, but you know, these are young lads. We don't want them to be under any pressure. What do you think they should be focusing now after getting a crucial victory? Regardless,
Ayo, pressure wa.
Okay, for those who don't understand
if we lose, if this country goes to lose, what is going to happen is that we are going to be crucified. So the issue here
should
is that
be the focus?
Team, listen attentively. The issue here is that the team should not lose against Chile. The issue of pressure, getting out of this, is just out of it totally. The issue here is that we have managed to win the last one, and we are defending it this time around. In as much as it's not for winning, it is to develop players and bring them to an expected end. The issue here is that this team must get to minimum semi-finals at least, and they started very, very well, getting the 3 points. So the issue here now is that against Chile, they must work very, very hard, and Chile is an high-altitude area. You can see that the movement of our ball in the last match is very, very slow. We have to increase this time around against the South Americans, manage to get a draw or a win, and fight Croatia to the end so that we qualify for the next stage.
Hmm. Okay. That's really, really important. Thank you so much for talking to us this morning. We'll definitely call you again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very, very much. God will bless you.
Thank you so much.